JT Plus. Young Dreams. Yeah. J Plus. Streets knew me. Since I was a little nappy head nigga, way before I started smoking, or ever made a figure. Way before I started to rap, I was rocking my cousin's sneakers and starting for scraps. I just wanted a little brother, plus had me some change. So at night, I prayed for miracles and shit never came. Paying skippies on my feet, running fog for the winter troop. Couldn't get the Timbs, dog, couldn't get the triple hoop. Couldn't get a chain, stepfather stole my ring and sold it. Just so he could smoke some cook cocaine. Enough was enough for being legit. Me and Nat started doing all types of shit. Breaking open soda machines and passing them out. All the niggas knowing my name, I'm happening now. Mama moved me out the city of BK. Back to being all by my lonesome, we headed to VA. The streets knew me, never had it goldy. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding in the funeral. Way before I became J Dread, before I ever lit a blunt and planted a blaze of the head.
Right.
Way before I sold me some crack, before I ever copped a bottle, and pour me some yak. Life changed, new step pop, and a new state. Never frontin' like I'm hard, kept the dude safe. Never holdin' like I'm soft, niggas steady knowing. Early signs of being great, I'm already showing. Got a job, same time, started stealing clothes. Knew it wasn't right, but it kept the boy feeling dope. Got high with that first time, 11th grade. Couldn't imagine I'd be blazing like I do today. Graduated to community college, but instead of pursuing the knowledge, I'm moving to scammer. Got arrested, lost the weed, plus stuck in the jail. Hope the judge let me out, cause mama ain't got bail. Hell.
The streets knew me, never had it goldy. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding in the funeral.
Way before I became Young Trees, before I pointed guns at George saying, give me the cheese. Before I ever tried to get a deal, I was selling crack for a living so I could get a meal. Bad record, can't get a job, paying more than $6. But I can make 600 in 6 hours. I'm flipping powder, hard getting sour. Cook it up, sell it all, now I'm getting power. Me, D, and Wise, all we getting hours. We distribute the work, call us Martin Brower. I distribute the hurt, call me Tiny Lister. Gripping guns, both hands, palm got the tiny blisters. When I'm in jail, call me inmate Fisher. Got the juice aiming at you, nigga, you could call me Bishop. Now switch up, spit straight vicious. I'm shunning niggas like they pop, make them do the dishes.
The streets knew me, never had it goldy. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding individual. The streets knew me, never had it goldy. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me, but the streets knew me. Soldiers to a general, cradle to the grave, outstanding individual.
Alabama's number one DJ, DJ Ad Low, is in the building.
You are tuned into the Underground Railroad Show with that nigga on Speaker.com. What's going on, fam? What you know, good, man? Y'all know what it is. It's another show kicking off on Monday. And I got an audio issue right off the bat.
Testing 1 2 1 2, and we are clear. All right, let's try that one more time. This is the Underground Railroad Show with that nigga on Speaker.com. What's going on with you, fam? Same thing happened last week. That's a damn shame. All right, we got it straightened out. We good. All right, man, appreciate y'all coming aboard, man. Okay, I get it. The train's been on hiatus for about a week or so. Let me explain myself, because I didn't inform everybody. It's also become aware to me that you might have been led to believe that the show was coming on when it wasn't, so allow me to explain myself on that. Alright, last week, a little tied up, and in half my fault, I didn't communicate this with our fearless leader. I didn't holler at Doug, you know, shoot him a text, and I was kind of busy, you know, life gets in the way. So I haven't communicated with him. So last week I didn't have time to do the show and get the train rolling, because TSA had a what did they call it? They called it a play date. For those that don't know, she plays volleyball. She just made a school team this year. So they had their little play date last week, and they had games Monday and Tuesday. So I wasn't in a position where I could do the show, but I didn't necessarily relate that to Doug. And I think I've become aware that it was promoted like the show was going to come on at the regular scheduled time. So my bad for that. For anybody that thought the show might have been coming on and I didn't communicate what I was going to do, that's on me. But as far as like the time today, again, my bad. Didn't talk to Doug. Had some things going on. Couldn't get the train rolling at its normal time. So I'm kicking off at this particular moment. But having said all that, appreciate everybody coming aboard, man. Thank y'all for rolling with me. It's been a minute. Feel like been a little bit. Y'all know I consider this therapy and a little bit of stress relief. So, hell, probably a little bit stressed because I haven't done the show. Appreciate y'all rolling with me. Appreciate you coming aboard. Let me do it right off the bat. Thank you to everybody that has come aboard the train and is listening up. Thank you to everybody that jumps in the car, gets your ticket stubs and allows yourself to be seen. Give me a little back and forth in the chat. Appreciate y'all as well. And thank you to everybody that's going to listen on demand at your convenience and or leisure. No doubt. Appreciate that. Always, man. Always. All right. Y'all know what it is. Quote unquote, there's been a story today going on talking about Colin Kaepernick. Generally speaking, I don't follow whatever the mainstream narrative is of the day. I will speak about this particular subject, but obviously I'm not going to come at it in the manner that everybody else has, or at least I don't think I am. The main thing I'm going to discuss about it is I think it would be healthy and or advantageous if we stop talking around it. If we're going to talk about it, let's talk about what it is. And we can do that in perception versus reality.
The drums. All right. Yeah. All right.
Here come the drums.
The wood, so the people give you some of that reaction to the facts that I kick in a stick in a stay around point to the joint.
Put the bullet down.
In today's perception versus reality, kind of touching on, I guess, what you would call the mainstream topic of the day, but, you know, it's not necessarily my normal go about. But my thoughts. Okay, everybody's been talking about Colin Kaepernick, and the thing to me, it's just like, you see the title, ninjas have short memories. I'm not worried about people, I'm worried about us. Ninjas have short memories. What I mean by that, it's like, you know, I think I said this before, but you know the old adage, the old saying, if you don't know your history, you're doing to repeat it, you know, corny crap like that. I guess my thing is, what I'm saying is that none of this is new, none of it should be surprising, none of it is things we haven't seen. So, you know what? I took a quick little check at the chat, and I see Denise in here joking on me about not saying nothing to Doug about not being, I was busy, my bad. But so I will admit, half of it is my fault by not communicating. I digress. Let's get back to what I was saying. My whole thing with the cabinet thing, man, is why we're talking around it. Why are we acting surprised? Why are we acting as if we don't know what the hell we're dealing with as far as this country? This country, the people in it, the way it operates on a higher level, when you talk about economics and companies and entities that have a lot of power and influence. There's a reason why when you look on CNN and Fox, for the most part, every black person who worked there has the same kind of look and attitude. Nobody's really overly aggressive and militant. They have to be somewhat down the middle, otherwise you can't work there. There's not really a diversity in the type of people they hire, because even if you are a ninja, you must behave in a certain manner. So any type of corporate entity requires a certain type of behavior. And I guess my thing about ninjas having short memories, it's not like Colin Kaepernick is even the first victim of just a black quarterback not being able to play. First and foremost, you know, if people aren't familiar with my show, again, man, forgive me. For people that aren't familiar with my show, man, it's always been my opinion. Myself and Jungle Brother, we kind of echo this a lot, that there is a blatant and obvious campaign against black quarterbacks in college and pro. A little bit more to the pro level, and I'll tell you why I believe this would be the case. And this is part of the issue of why Colin Kaepernick isn't signed on top of everything else. But there's already a natural bias against black quarterbacks. My theory is that if you're not great, if you don't have the potential to be legendary, if you're not extreme,